Okay, that'll do. Oh.
Hey!
Well, that was great. Thank you for that. Well, welcome everyone. What a terrible year it's been, and Christmas has sort of gone up in smoke for a lot of people in Britain, so we thought we'd invite you all to do a sort of online Christmas thing. Thank you for that lovely rendition of Silent Night, which was, in fact, originally composed on the guitar by a Catholic priest and his organist. And the organ was damaged by a river, and they had to quickly come up with a hymn on the guitar, so that was actually a more authentic version of Silent Night than you tend to hear.
Just how it was in 1827.
Exactly, yeah. Shall we have the lights?
Shall we do some lights? Can we add a little bit of lights?
Lights.
So, here we are again. We haven't done
slick and professional.
Done a live stream in quite a while, but we thought we'd just come back for this Christmas one. I'm Charlie. This is Polly, Romany, Janina, David. The baby is called Alinka.
Babunia has
the dog is buggered off. It's been a year where it's been very easy to focus on the negative. So I thought we could talk about the positive. What's been everyone's sort of highlight of 2020? I know what mine is.
Go on, you start.
In terms of cultural output,
it's been
Merlin Sheldrake's Entangled Life, which is a sort of roller coaster ride through the hidden world of fungi. And it's really changed the way I think about a whole order of life forms and has started a sort of obsession with mushrooms. It's a book that sort of does evangelism for the Mushroom Kingdom.
And very successfully in your case.
What's been your highlight?
Well, actually, my highlight of recent weeks has been watching you plant a mushroom forest. Because there's never a moment when Charlie isn't drilling into bits of wood and putting in mushroom.
Okay. So mushrooms have also been your highlight.
Well, no, that's not the highlight. The highlight of my year, obviously, is to do with my obsession with Charmian Cliff. And when I wrote a novel in which she figures, the highlight of my year has been hearing from people who read it, but even bigger than that, which has been a hugely wonderful thing, is the publisher Muswell Press, who are putting her back into print, which is everything I wished for. So that's been keeping me cheerful and busy because I've written the introductions.
Yeah. Everyone watching, wherever you are, if you've got any highlights, the sort of best thing that's happened this year, the best thing you've read or listened to, please do get your comments in, because we'd love to hear about it. Anybody else? Daddy, what have been your sort of...
I've been enjoying all my family's highlights. Polly's Theatre for Dreamers, we had such a lot of fun. Now Charlie's Featherhood, and the live streams that we've been doing here and there, a little erratically, but those have been the joyful moments.
Actually,
really,
the joyful moment also is having these people sort of basically locked in with us.
Yeah.
I mean,
because we worked on like slaves. Yeah.
Romany, your best of 2020?
Dump Trump.
Mm.
Watched a lot of good films, usually about women going insane, but, you know, written by men. And they always have great hair and great makeup the entire time they're going insane, but still very good films.
Like what?
Images. Mm-hmm. I watched. I've been watching the Polish director, the films based on Decalogue.
Kieslowski,
yes. Okay. Music by Zbigniew Preisner.
Yeah. Yep.
Alinka, what's been the highlight of your year?
What do you like the most, Baba? What do you love?
Eggs.
Yeah.
I love eggs too.
And Moomins.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Moomins is definitely Olinka's highlight.
Janina, what's been the highlight of your year?
Definitely, it feels like an enormous privilege to have spent so much time with Olinka, but also, I think, to grow vegetables, because I wouldn't have that continuity of time to actually engage in it in that sort of way, so that has been actually the really, really amazing thing, to grow vegetables and plants as well.
Oh, baby.
Oh, my puppy, my poor puppy.
Yeah, and we also have Christmas crackers, so I wish there was a way I could sort of extend this cracker through the screen and pull it with those of you watching at home.
Thank you, Linka.
Maybe we should do these crackers. So we've got some hats and some jokes. And yeah, if you're watching and you have a cracker, feel free.
Why doesn't David go stand back
behind
there?
The
we can pull them all with him.
we'll do one at least.
All right, one.
Okay, you're ready behind the screen.
Oh, wow, a Linka crack.
What's inside?
Wow.
Keep winning them.
Oh, well, I seem to have got the notebook though out of that one.
Oh, they're actual cool things.
Here you go, Romany. Here's your hat.
Oh, okay.
Obviously, lots of the people here have produced a lot of cultural things. You've done your book, A Theatre of Dreamers. I've done my book, Featherhood.
Yeah, but they were done before.
They were done, but they were out this year. You two have done your single together.
Yep.
Yes, I Have Ghosts.
Yes, I Have Ghosts, written by Polly.
Yeah.
Performed by me, with Romany singing along and playing harp, so...
And it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful song, if I may say so. I know I'm biased, but it is a really lovely song, and you're going to perform it for... Is it the first time it's been performed this evening?
Yeah, I think... I mean, you know, when you record it, you sort of hate to disillusion people, but you play the guitar first, and then you sing afterwards, and I don't think I've actually... played and sung it all the way through.
No, I don't think you have.
At all.
Well, good luck.
Anyway, so that's...
No pressure.
No pressure.
Then.
It's just singing a song. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? Hey, Ro?
Do you two want to do that now?
Oh, can I just say another really nice thing of this year is Romany taking up the harp. Because there have been these sort of awful, depressed mornings in bed where suddenly Romany playing the harp in the room underneath, and it's sort of coming through the floorboards, has really, really rescued me. It's the most beautiful instrument, and
it is a beautiful instrument.
I definitely
filled been playing that a lot.
When I was pregnant with her, when I filled in the form, that was one of the things I filled in. And
see, that was her achievement that she forgot to mention.
Yeah,
the thrill of the all that beautiful harp playing.
I forgot that you get terrible jokes in crackers. Joke. Yeah. It's also that they have to write joke.
Yeah.
To let you know that
in
it is a joke.
That, yeah.
Joke. What happened to the man who stole an advent calendar?
Crazy.
He got 25 days. I don't think that's funny.
What? I don't suppose you do, Charlie.
Okay. What do you call a deer with a bad eye?
Bad idea.
Mm. I have quite a good one. How will Christmas dinner be different after Brexit?
No, ooh, that's not what it says.
Yeah, it does.
It's a Brexit joke.
Oh, no turkey.
No.
No food, in fact.
No food at all. Yeah, that's correct. No, it says no Brussels, but I'm sure there'll be other things too.
No Brussels. I knew it was something to do with the European country.
Oh, didn't someone have a question about Brussels sprouts?
Yes, we'll get on to questions. If you've got any questions, get them in, please. But now, shall we have the very, very first live performance of Yes, I Have Ghosts?
Ooh, all right. Alinka?
Come here, Babbitt.
Come. Okay, let's hope I can summon the lyrics out of the crevices of my mind.
I'll be very hurt if you can't.
Yeah. Well, I cannot. Okay, that's the first line, right? Very good. Okay. I'll be ready. Alinka, are you listening to the pretty music?
Okay, it's good to growl.
Anyway.
The heat of the sun stayed on through the night, made specters of strangers playing games with my sight. I passed through the station, a face in the crowd. A whistle was blowing, the barrier came down. There was my baby in another's embrace. I called out her name in shame and disgrace. Yes, I have ghosts, not all of them dead, making dust of my dreams, spinning round and around, around in my head. Train on the tracks, teeth of the zip, the slider moves down, we were joined at the hip. Stealing the groove, the widening gap, unfastening rails from a past with no map. Yes, I have ghosts, a fleeting sight. It's always the living that are haunting my nights. Where soul that used to be, gone like a thistle that's blown on the breeze. I guess when it's over, this haunting will end. The waiting, the baiting, my killer, my friend. Yes, I have ghosts, not all of them dead, and they dance by the moon, millstones white as the sheets on my bed.
Lovely. Right. We've been sent in a few questions, and to everyone watching, at the end of this, we started with Silent Night,
yeah.
And I thought we could end it with singing Silent Night. And everyone watching, if you want to sing along, please see, we've got a good choir master here who's going to choose
we'll be
everyone
listening
in how to sing it. So we're going to run through some of the questions that have been sent in, and there are some more questions that have been sent in live, so let's have a look at some of those. Scott Roark, I think we have a good idea who names the songs. Who does name the songs? You. My question is, who names the dogs?
Nina.
Thank you very much and Merry Christmas.
I think I might name the dogs as
well. You also
well.
Name the dogs, yeah. Words and sounds.
Yeah. David plays them nice music.
Too cool. Maybe it's just me, but does the room resemble Twin Peaks' waiting room? Janina, you can feel this one.
Yes, that's what it is.
Well spotted.
Yeah. So on Twitter, Mao42, favourite Christmas song in the household? Anyone got a favourite Christmas song?
Silent Night, Hark the Herald?
Yeah, Silent Night.
Hark the Herald, I'm sure that we have, but we've just forgotten.
Catherine B, what's your funniest moment in this strange year? Anyone got a funniest moment?
Oops.
I mean, most of them don't really translate. I mean,
no.
I've got one. Maybe I'll just sit with one, which is that we basically don't really see anyone at all from the outside world. And so when me and Romany were walking back to the house, we saw someone with brown hair outside the house. And we both said, hello, Mummy, hello. And it wasn't her, it was actually a man with brown hair who had come to give some medicine to the sheep.
And we were screaming,
and was quite
Mommy
confused.
At him.
So that was that.
Oh, and there was also the time that when we were putting the newspapers in the oven, and Alinka once sort of just was learning to toddle, and she walked up to the oven and she switched it up, and the newspapers kept set
that,
fire.
Yeah.
We rolled on the floor laughing in that.
Favourite Christmas films?
Sound of Music.
Romany, Die Hard?
Pirates of the Caribbean,
of the
which
Caribbean.
Isn't a Christmas film,
really?
But it's my Christmas film.
Is it?
But yeah, because Joe and Gabriel and I always used to watch all of them every year.
Daddy, here's one for you. Park Slope Scott. How old and what is the history of this? We're actually in a barn. What's the history of it and how old is it?
Well, it's a pretty old barn. I really have no idea of the date it was built, but it could be a couple of hundred years old for all I know. I really don't know.
You don't know, okay.
It's old.
I thought you'd know.
What would it... Because it's got some quite specific... You can't really see if you're watching, but it's got all these sort of wheels and mechanisms and things. I mean, presumably these would give some clue as to what it was used for.
Well, we could ask...
We don't know, okay.
Someone who knows, but right. I don't.
Laurie Wolfschlag... What's the most surprising thing you've learnt this year, either about yourself, your family, or a skill? Anyone?
I have no new skills.
You've got no new skills.
Not much in the way of new skills. Mm. Charlie's got some very good mushroom skills.
Mushroom skills, yeah. Janina, you've picked up quite a few new skills.
Janina's done all the skills.
That's my average life, though.
Yeah.
I really learned a lot about medicinal plants. That's my top skill, I would say.
Richard...
Oh, Alinka learnt to walk.
She's learnt to walk and talk and stuff. Yeah, that is big. Richard Drawlings, has anyone, this is related to the song we just heard, has anyone seen or heard a ghost before?
Yes.
Romany?
So, I was in the shower, and it was locked, there's a glass door in the shower, man in a long duffel coat walked past, got out, and there was no one there, went up to my room, all of the things flew off the desk, and then we found out that the man who used to live there... Okay, Alinka, was a lifelong member of the Ghost Club Society and wrote books called Ghosts and Hauntings, and every person who stays there comments on a person standing at the end of the sofa at night.
David might want to add to this story. Whose father is this man?
This is...
Because we knew this man.
Well, we knew this man. He was called Dennis Barbens. He was a very nice old gentleman who actually, I believe, founded Panorama and was quite into the paranormal. His son, Peter Bardens, was a musician in the 60s in England who was part of the formation of all those bands like Shotgun Express and Fleetwood Mac. I mean, he wasn't actually in Fleetwood Mac, but he lived in the Muse, and Mick Fleetwood actually lived in the same place, right, practically next door, as he told me recently.
Anyway, we knew Dennis.
Anyway, Dennis was a lovely old boy.
Yeah.
So, on to a different but related subject. This year, many people, especially in Britain, their Christmas has been sent slightly sideways. But I was thinking about Christmas, the ghost of Christmas past. Do you have any particular... What was your Christmas like as a child?
Oh. Well, I mean, as a small child, probably quite standard Christmas. But I think when I was about 9, maybe, my mother, who had grown up in, among other places, an orphanage, Dr. Bernardo's home, decided that... Christmas was a sort of despicable institution. I mean, I kind of get her point. And so she added up the cost of every present, every bit of tinsel, every last bit of turkey, and she sent a cheque to Dr. Bernardo's, the charity. And so every year, we didn't really have Christmas, but we were told that she'd added the rate of inflation, and this cheque had gone to Dr. Bernardo's.
Well, some happy orphans.
Yes.
But unhappy you.
Well, I mean, you know, happy in one way.
Daddy, what were your Christmases like as a child? Because you had, how many siblings? You had...
I was one of four. Yeah. One was 7 or 8, 7 years younger, so he didn't figure for a while.
Yeah.
But no, we had very lovely Christmases at home in Cambridge.
Stocking?
Stockings, of course, yes. Mm.
Who did the cooking in your household?
My dad was the family cook.
Excellent. Mm.
Interesting.
And that seems to be
that's passed
a role
on.
That I've inherited.
I made the Christmas pudding.
Mm. Janina, what was your... Because your first Christmases would have been in the Soviet Union.
Yeah. You don't really celebrate Christmas. You do a lot of the same stuff, have a Christmas tree and all of that, but you celebrate New Year's.
Mm.
And the few things I remember, because I was so young, was that it was really amazing. I mean, very beautiful, because you would... I remember my parents taking us to these public celebrations where you would have this enormous Christmas tree. I mean, they probably weren't that big, but... and just very... It's very full-on, quite kitsch, like a lot of tinsel, a lot of shiny baubles, like really good...
Would Jesus have been much involved in communist Christmas?
I didn't know about Jesus at all. There was no mention of Jesus.
No mention of Jesus.
But then Sweden was really nice as well, because it's more pagan, sort of, and I think it does really connect back, because it is so dark. It's dark almost the whole time during winter, and just have the lights and have all of this greenery is really connecting back, I think, to what this tradition is about, which is to bring in
the light.
Yeah, bring in the light, bring in the spring and summer in a completely dark and withered sort of existence.
And this Christmas will probably be the first one that Alinka has a chance of possibly remembering. Alinka, are you making memories there?
No.
No. Romany, any Christmas memories you'd like to share?
Joe Gabriel and I used to pass round a silver fish flask with caramel vodka in.
Did you?
Oh. Is it, I didn't realise it was confessions tonight.
True confession.
What do you mean used to? When? Where? What? Why didn't I get a silver fish with caramel vodka in? Why wasn't I included in this?
But what's a
Where
silver
is this
fish?
Caramel
I've never met a silver fish.
The quite ornate little silver fish flask. I've never.
I'll look out for it.
We've got time for a couple more questions, so anyone got any questions? Quick! Oh, your finger's stuck in the harp. Anyone got any more questions? Get them in very quickly. Justin Lee Thomas, I guess this is a question for both of us. Any more books in the future?
God, I mean, I hope so. I mean, this year has, you know, is I think the part of the brain that sort of writes before you ever touch a keyboard has just been worrying.
Yeah.
Been worrying.
Come on, Dada.
Well, where are we going? We're going to Brighton.
Okay, bye.
Okay.
Bye. I don't know if that's allowed.
How are you going to ask questions? You've dropped your phone.
Yeah. I'm being led somewhere.
Oh.
You are being led astray.
Well, perhaps that's a cue that, Daddy, you should start tutoring people to how to sing
Silent Night.
Silent
yes, do
Night.
Quickly.
Here are the words.
Okay.
What are the chords, David?
Well, it's in the key of C, or that the one that we did. I need to find my glasses now. Okay. Could have typed them a little bit bigger. Here we are. There's a copy.
Oh, thank you.
Are we?
Oh, is Baba going to sing that?
Yes.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Here, Charlie, have a piece of paper.
Poo-poo. Have you done a poo-poo?
Are you not playing, David?
We haven't done a poo-poo. You're lying.
Baby, this song is about Jesus.
Baby Jesus.
Oh, she said.
Right.
Not that was singing.
Are we
singing.
All ready?
Is Romany not playing? No.
I mean, everyone knows it, so all you got to do is join in and sing.
Starting
in this key.
I can't
so everyone at home.
Actually, I don't think I've ever heard you sing in my life.
I don't.
Right.
You ready?
One, two, three, two, two.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender. In heavenly peace.
Another verse.
Silent night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight, glorious stream from heaven afar, heavenly host. Sing hallelujah. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
Does that say there's actually one more verse.
There is one more verse. you...
Well,
I was editing.
Were we not good at singing?
What? No, we were lovely at singing.
Well, Mary...
Well, no, I think now David should get back on the electric guitar.
Yeah.
And he should just send us out into the night, soloing away.
Oh, yes. Can we have some really scary licks?
Yeah, come on.
Really scary licks. I'm...
Come on. just do the first solo from Comfortably Numb.
Oh, okay.
Really scary.
Followed by the second one.
Oh, we've got a question on Instagram. Do you guys like baking Christmas cookies? Who's the best at it?
Well, obviously, I like David's cookies best.
Yeah. Do you?
Yes.
Who's...
Linka.
David.
No, 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 no.
I can't hear a minesweeper.
Linka.
Here I am.
Linka.
I don't know where the back is.
Shouldn't you stand up, David?
I've done them all.
All right, shall we say Merry Christmas and good night?
Okay. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Good night.
Merry
good night.
Christmas, you Christmas. Filthy animals.
Great. I think that was good.
I think that
was a little rusty. But
yeah, I think David carried that one.
Yeah.